Sairam students, welcome to the first session of chapter 16, that is preparation of algebra. Now what is algebra? Algebra, it consists of the use of numbers and letters to state and solve the problems. So that means we are going to use numbers also, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on, and letters also, that is A, B, C, D and so on, right? So now first let's see what is equality. When we add, subtract, multiply or divide two numbers, the answer we get is always another number, right? So whenever we are doing addition, subtraction, multiplication or division, we are doing it between the two numbers. So always we will get another number. So let's see. So when we add 5 and 3, so 5 plus 3, what we get the number? We get the number 8, right? Now 13 minus 6, what number you get? 7. 12 divided by 4, you get the number 3. And 9 into 1, you get the number 9. So whatever numbers we are taking, the two numbers, and we are getting a different number. Now, suppose if we take the number 12, children. So we have to find out the pairs of number 12, right? So how do we find out the pairs? Like suppose if I take 6 plus 6 is equal to 12, right? So this is one pair, 6 plus 6, you get the answer as 12. Now like this you can make many numbers, right? Not only 6 plus 6, 7 plus 5 is also 12, 8 plus 4 is also 12. So like this any two numbers you can take, but the answer should be 12, right? Now suppose, now what will be the next pair? Suppose in subtraction, how will you make the pair? I will take 13 minus 1 is equal to 12, right? Again, I'm getting the answer 12. So like this, you can take any two numbers, you can subtract, but answer should be 12. Next, if I take multiplication, now multiplication, what I will do? 4 into 3 is equal to 12. So again, I have got the answer as 12. Any two numbers you multiply. 6 into 2 also you can take. 12 into 1 also you can take, right? And the last one is division. Now for division, what I will do? I will take 36 divided by 3. So what do I get? Answer is 12, because 12 3 is 36. So this 6 plus 6, 13 minus 1, 4 into 3 and 36 divided by 3, these are all the pairs of the number 12, right? So as I told you, 6 plus 6, 15 minus 3, 6 into 2 and 24 divided by 2. Right? You can take any pairs of numbers, not necessary that whatever I have taken, that only you have to take, right? But answer should be 12. Now if you see all these numbers, they are all pairs of the numbers which give you the answer as 12. So a number obtained by adding 6 and 6, you get 6 is equal to 6 plus 6, right? Then 15 minus 3 means what? A number obtained by subtracting 3 from 15, right? So a number obtained means 12 is your number which you have obtained by subtracting 3 from 15. Next is 6 into 2 means what? A number obtained by multiplying 6 by 2. And 24 divided by 2 means a number obtained by dividing 24 by 2. So now arrangements like 6 plus 6, 15 minus 3, 6 into 2, 24 divided by 2, these are all called as expressions, right? Whatever you are writing in brackets, bracket 6 plus 6, close the bracket, like this, they are called expressions. Now the value of each expression is 12, which means all these expressions, they are equal to each other, right? If you take 6 plus 6 expression, you get the answer 12. If you take the expression 6 into 2, you get the answer 12. So any of these expressions which you can see on the screen, that will give you the answer 12. That means they are all equal to each other. So we can write it as 6 plus 6 is equal to 15 minus 3, or 6 plus 6 is equal to 6 into 2. Right? So because 6 plus 6 is equal to 12 and 15 minus 3 is 12. So 12 is equal to 12. Similarly here, 6 plus 6 is 12 and 6 2's is 12. So 12 equals to 12. So that's the reason we are writing 6 plus 6 is equal to 15 minus 3 and 6 plus 6 is equal to 6 into 2. Similarly, you can write 6 into 2 is equal to 24 divided by 2 and 6 into 2 is equal to 15 minus 3. If you solve this, what do you get? 6 2's are 12 and 24 divided by 2 also you get 12. So 12 is equal to 12. Again, 6 2's are is 12, 15 minus 3 is also 12. So that's the reason we can give an equality sign for these expressions. So an expression such as 6 plus 6 is equal to 15 minus 3 or 6 into 2 is equal to 24 divided by 2 is called as an equality, right? Because both the sides you will get the same answer, 12 is equal to 12. So we can write 6 plus 6 is equal to 15 minus 3 or 6 into 2 is equal to 24 divided by 2. Now, problem set 54 we are going to solve. Using brackets, write 3 pairs of numbers whose sum is 13. Use them to write 3 equalities, right? So what we are going to do, you have to find out the pair of number whose sum is 13. Now sum is 13 means addition, right? So like this, you have to write 3 equalities. Right? So you will find 2 numbers whose sum is 13. So like this you are going to find out 3 pairs of numbers. So now let's find out the pairs of 13. Right? So what I have done, I have taken 5 plus 8. So 5 plus 8 is 13. Then 12 plus 1. 12 plus 1 is also 13. And 10 plus 3. That is also 13. So children, you can take any other number, but their sum should be 13, right? It is not necessary that whatever numbers I have taken, only those will give you the sum as 13. There are many other numbers whose sum can be 13. So we have to write the equalities, right? So how will you write the equalities? You can take 5 plus 8 is equal to 12 plus 1. And then 12 plus 1 is equal to 10 plus 3. And then last one, 5 plus 8 is equal to 10 plus 3. So these are the 3 equalities. In 3 ways you can write this equalities. Let's move to the second sum. Find 4 pairs of numbers, one each for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, that make the number 18. Write equalities for each of them. Now here what they have given? They have given the number 18, right? And here what they have given? You have to find out addition, subtraction, multiplication and division also, right? So now we will find out. How do you do it now? Now 18 number is there. For addition, what you will take? I have taken here 12 plus 6. So 12 plus 6 is equal to 18. So you can also take any number of your choice, children. 9 plus 9 also you can take, right? Next, addition over. Now I'll take one subtraction. 19 minus 1 is how much? 18, right? So like this you can also do it. 20 minus 2 also you can take. So that also will give you 18. Next is 9 2's are 18. Right, you can also take 6 3's are 18. Then 36 divided by 2, you get the answer 18. Right, you can take any other pairs also. Right, so now I have taken addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So we got 4 pairs of numbers. Now we will write their equalities. So how do you write? 12 plus 6 is equal to 19 minus 1. Then what the second will be 19 minus 1 is equal to 9 into 2. And then 9 into 2 is equal to 36 divided by 2. And 9 into 2 is equal to 12 plus 6. So all will be equality signs because all the equations they are equal. When you solve them, you will get the 18 is equal to 18, right? Now, what is meant by inequality? Now, inequality means which is not equal, right? Now, we are taking two numbers, 7 and 5. Now, 7 plus 5 is equal to, it is 12, right? Similarly, if we take 7 into 5, you get the answer 35. Now, that means, now you can see 12 and 35. They are two different numbers. You do not get the same number, right? 7 into 5, you do not get 12. You get the answer as 35. So, that means 7 plus 5 and 7 into 5, they are not equal. So, the symbol for not equal is this symbol, right? Equal to and one slash is given. So, we can write 7 plus 5 is not equal to 7 into 5. So, this kind of representation is called as inequality. Means which are not equal to each other, they are called as inequality. So, if both the equations, if you take 7 plus 5 and 7 into 5, if you get the same answer, then only it is equal. And if you do not get the same answer, that means it is inequal. Right, students? So, let's take one more example. 9 minus 5 is equal to 4. And 15, when you divide by 3, you get the answer 5. Right? So, that means 9 minus 5 and 15 divided by 3. They are not equal because you are getting different answers. When you solve 9 minus 5, you get the answer 4. And 15, when you divide by 3, you get the answer 5. So, 4, it is not equal to 5. Right? So, that's the reason we can write 9 minus 5 is not equal to 15 divided by 3. Or you can write the other way around also. 15 divided by 3 is not equal to 9 minus 5. Now children, we'll take another type of sum. 9 minus 5 is equal to 4. And 15 divided by 3, you get the answer as 5. Now 4, it is smaller than 5, right? You all know about it. So that's the reason we can write 9 minus 5 is smaller than 15 divided by 3. Because if you solve 9 minus 5, you get the answer 4. And 15 divided by 3, you get the answer 5. That means 4 is smaller than 5. Right? Fill in the boxes between the expressions with smaller than, equal to, or greater than as required. So, now what is given? 9 plus 8 in brackets, box, and then 30 divided by 2, it is in bracket. So, first what we will do children, 9 plus 8, we will solve that. So, what you get? 17. And 30 when you divide by 2, what answer do you get? 15. Right? Now, 17, it is greater than 15. So, you can write 17 is greater than 15. So, that is the reason you will write 9 plus 8 is greater than 30 divided by 2. Right? So, as I told you, 9 plus 8 is equal to 17 and 30 divided by 2 is equal to 15. So, 17 is greater than 15. So, therefore, 9 plus 8 is greater than 30 divided by 2, right? So, let's take the second example. 16 into 3 box and then 4 into 12. So, what you are going to do? First, you will solve the bracket. 16 3 za is how much? 48. And 12 4 za is how much? 48. So, 48 is equal to 48. That means you can write 16 into 3 is equal to 4 into 12, right? So, like this you will solve it. 16 3s are 48, 4 12s are 48. So, 48 is equal to 48. So, therefore, 16 into 3 is equal to 4 into 12. Now let's take the third example. 16 minus 5 and 2 into 7. So what is 16 minus 5 children? 11. And what is 2 sevens are? 14. So 11, it is smaller than 14. So that's the reason you can write 16 minus 5 is smaller than 2 into 7. Right? So you will write 16 minus 5 is 11. 2 into 7 is 14. So 11, it is smaller than 14. So therefore 16 minus 5 is smaller than 2 into 7. Write a number in the box that will make this statement correct. So what is the first one? 7 into 2 is equal to box minus 6. So you have to fill the number over here. Right? Now what is 7 2's are? 7 2's are is 14. Right? Now here what do you have to find out? You have to find out the number. When you subtract it from 6, you should get the answer as 14. Right? So what I will do? 14, I have got the answer. So 14 plus 6, how much I get? 20. So 20 minus 6, when I do, I get the answer as 14 only. Right? So what you can write? You can write 7 2's are 14. 20 minus 6 is 14. So 14 is equal to 14. So that's the reason 7 into 2 is equal to 20 minus 6. What is the second one? 24 divided by 3 is greater than 5 plus box. So children, 24 divided by 3 is what? 8. Right? Now here 5 plus box is given. Right? And it should be, now this number 8, it should be smaller than the number which you are going to get over here. Right? Now what you can do, small, it should be bigger than 8, right? So what I can do, 5 plus 3 is 8. So it will become equal to sign. 5 plus 4, it will be 9. So 8, it is smaller than 9. So I can write in the box as 5 plus 4. That means I get the answer as 9, right? So it is not necessary that you have to take 4 only. You can take 5 plus 5 also. That means 8, it's greater than 10. Right? It should not be a smaller number. You cannot take 5 plus 2 because 5 plus 2 is 7 and 7, it is smaller than 8. We want a number which is more than 8 over here in the box. Right? So that's why you can take 4, 5, 6, 7, any other number, but not less than 4. Understood? So 8, it is smaller than 9. So that's the reason we can write 24 divided by 3 is smaller than 5 plus 4. So I will write 24 divided by 3 is 8 and 5 plus 4 is 9. So 8, it is smaller than 9. So you can write 24 divided by 3 is smaller than 5 plus 4. Understood, children? So I hope, students, you have understood what is equality, inequality, how to solve the expressions and put a greater sign or smaller than sign or equal to sign. So in the next session, children, we will solve problem set 55. Till then, goodbye.